your hearts? Are you giving your hearts this morning? Oh, I give
I know.
working. The Spirit of the Lord is working. Thank you. so sad that people worship man instead of God. Look at how many people are here. Sad. Friday, I was watching people that walked away because prophet was not around. Reverend, my heart was sorrowful. Are we building empire or we are building disciples? What you are looking for? Do you know what you really want?
No relationship.
I was here. I was just standing there. Somebody said, "Is prophet around?" No. About 10. And people just walked in and walked out when they saw prophet Chris preaching. Brethren, what are we doing? Are we working in vain? No, let me tell you. Let me say the truth. Sometimes it grieves me and it grieves the spirit. It means we don't have a church. If we continue to do this, are we enemy of progress? Do we want to cripple the church? So can prophet travel and extend the gift to other people too? Yes. Brethren, it's about time. It is about time. The time is past overdue that we change. Can't you come and worship and work towards your own salvation with fear and trembling? The Bible says, since the days of John the Baptist, what days are we in now? Since those days, the kingdom suffered and the Father took it. We are joking. That canal Christianity must stop. Canal Christianity, it must stop.
Hallelujah.
When prophets, that is why people cannot stay at one place and worship. Roaming ambassadors from one church to the other. Morning service here, afternoon service somewhere. Prophet is doing what God is telling him to do. What are you doing? God is still here and he is working as I'm talking right now. His spirit is working. Does it mean prophet travel with God?
No.
Do you know what time God woke me up this morning and was talking to me?
Amen.
And telling me what to tell his people?
Amen. 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 Amen.
Brethren, God is no respecter of person. He can use anybody. That is why sometimes we miss God's blessings in so many ways. Because we look at what God is not looking at.
Hallelujah.
You know what you missed on Friday? Turning away, God forbid. By going, do you know what would have happened to you on the way? Are you serving Frank? Are you serving Prophet Frank? He is only the servant of God. God uses him to bless people, to deliver people. That does not mean you should put your trust in him. He is not God. Don't kill him for me. On time, no. I need him more than you need him. Hallelujah. Seriously. heart. My spirit is down. When I saw what some people did, if I'm God bless you for being here. Your labor will never be in vain. Whatever you are looking for, the Lord will give it to you in double portion. You are a faithful and good servant. If you want to see the faithful believers, you will see it when you are away, not when you are around. If you are looking for a seed, when you plant a seed, you leave the seed. After a while, you go and check on the seed and see how far it is doing. Have you seen somebody planting a tree and staying by the tree 24/7? The seed will struggle. Yes. Sometimes you see that it will sweat.
Yes.
And then you see that it will grow.
Yes.
By the time you go, it is ready to bear fruit. Yes. For you to have something to enjoy. By you, I don't know what kind of seed you are. We plant the seed. You want us to sit with you 24/7. Water it. I don't know what you want us to do anymore. How many years now? You still not growing, you still not bearing no fruits. Why occupy space? The Bible says a tree that does not bear fruit, it is cut and uprooted and thrown away. Hallelujah. Brethren, it won't be long. Jesus is coming. This army is not coming as a Messiah. He's not bringing no more grace. He is coming as a church to give each and every one according to your works. Hallelujah. Brethren, tell those people to stop. We are not building empire for ourselves. We are building kingdom of God. And we are building disciples that even when we are not around, we travel. Some of you can come here and minister. Amen. Brethren, we are in the end of the days. We are in the end time. It is about time we become serious in the Lord.
Amen.
And stop joking around. And the things that is happening each and every day. Doesn't those things speak to you that Jesus is coming? Wars, rumors of wars, people killing each other. What are we looking for again? It is the sign of the coming. Brethren, if you are alive, it's not by your beauty, or it's not by enemy, it is by the grace. As I'm talking to you right now, somebody is breathing the last breath.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, it's grace.
Yes, yes.
You slept. You didn't know how you were going to wake up. You just jumped from your bed. The energy you had in you isn't by the grace of God. It is only, all you can do is to come to his house. And even if it's not preaching, just worship. Some of us, all we do know is, as soon as we jump from the bed, what we reach for is our phone. What you reach for is your phone. It is right by your bedside. And you are not even reaching the phone to read the Bible. You go in on YouTube, WhatsApp, Facebook, Snapchat. Early in the morning, is that all you can do? You cannot even say, thank you, Jesus. You just reach for your phone and you'll be flipping it. The way you flip your phone, is that how you flip the Bible? Brethren, certain things must change if you want to go to heaven. It is not that easy. It is work, and we have to work hard. And trust me, we don't have much time. Me, I live my life like every day there is no day. I live my life that I can go to heaven any other day. Jesus can come. I am not better than those that are dead. So if I wake up, I say, thank you for your grace. Give me that strength to go through the day. That is all I ask for. And stop reaching for your phone every minute. When you jump from your bed, when you are on your toilet, you reach your phone. Do you have time for yourself? For the Lord? Do you read your Bible? That is why we don't know our left and right. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor the Lord will help us. And God bless you for coming. Hallelujah. Amen. I am talking on the subject. The Lord told me this morning to tell you that don't die in silence. Hallelujah. I said what? Tell your neighbor sitting by you. Don't let anybody keep you down. Hallelujah. You have to reach your voice out. Let people know you. Let people know what you can do for the Lord. Don't die in silence.
Hallelujah.
Do you agree with me?
Yes.
We have a lot of people in the church of God these days. They die slowly. Inside, they are dying. But you don't know. When we come here, we all jump. We all die. You don't know when somebody is dying within. The Lord specifically told me. I had prepared earlier on. But just this morning, He told me, go and tell my people they shouldn't die in silence. So many people are intimidated. So many people are committing suicide because there is something in them is killing them. We don't know. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We have some Christians these days, they have some addiction that is killing them. They cannot tell anybody.
Very true.
We think addiction is only for unbelievers.
No.
When we say addiction, it's not only drug addiction.
No.
It's not only alcohol. Some people, they have gossip addiction. Yeah. It's killing them slowly.
Sure.
It's true. They have alcohol addiction.
Yes.
We have people in the house of God, they drink alcohol.
Yes.
If you sit here and you drink alcohol, it's a shame.
Yes.
If nobody sees you, the God in heaven is watching you.
Yes.
The Lord is telling me, don't die in that alcohol. Bring your voice out, say it, and ask for help. Come to why people are dying in silence. We will come and you will see how people are dying. Why? People are dying in the church. To us, we think that they are going to heaven. No.
You don't know.
You don't know what is going on in their lives. Some are addicted to pornography. You think that is this woman mad or something? What is it? I know what I'm talking about. And those things, if you don't say it here, who will tell you? We can't hide under the cloak of a hallelujah. Hallelujah! I said we can't hide under the cloak of hallelujah. In the house of God. You drink alcohol because you are somebody that everybody knows in the church. You think you have to hide it and do it. Stop. If not, you will die one day. And it is that thing that will kill you. Some are addicted to lies. They cannot help it. It's not your fault. You want to come out, but you are addicted to it. You find yourself gossiping all the time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you don't stop, that brings fake and carnality in the house of God.
Amen.
We are always pretending,
yes.
But things are not right. Yes. The Bible says, he who thinks he is standing, take heed. Addiction in the house of God. Don't die slowly. Don't die silently. Come out. Voice it out. You will get help.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you don't say it, you won't get help. Somebody is sitting for prophet to say it. Sometimes prophet will see it and he will not tell you. Because this country, if you say certain things, you have to be careful. So if you are here waiting for prophet to call you and tell you, my friend, you are a witch, it's not going to happen. So if you know you are a witch, you are a wizard. Say it! If you can do altar call for sinners, can't you do altar call for witchcraft? If you know you are a witch, come forward. I am doing altar call for witchcraft. Brethren, it's about time.
Yes.
If you can publicly declare certain things, you will be free.
Yes. Hallelujah.
That is why we don't get deliverance. Because sometimes we don't voice it out. Even when you are accepting Christ, you say certain things and you admit Christ into you.
Yes.
So there are certain things you have to say it loud.
Yes.
Amen.
Don't keep silent. Don't die in silence.
Amen.
You don't know how many people are dying. Jesus, the death that is coming is unbelievable. That will tell you that it's only by his grace.
Amen.
So if you have today, as you are sitting right here, don't joke with your life.
Amen.
He can come at any He won't give you the date. You don't know the hour. The time you least expected. You don't know how many people practice masturbation in the house of God. Addiction. They are addicted to it. They cannot come out of it. God says if you are not ready to go to heaven, it's not easy. They are doing it secretly.
Yes.
And it's killing them.
Yes.
Some of them want to even commit suicide because of that.
Yep.
They don't have the strength to come out. The Lord says, don't die in silence. Come out from among them and the Lord will bless you.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't die in silence, my dear. It's not worth it. There are so many problems going on these days. But if you are giving your life to Christ, you have to serve him with all your heart.
Amen.
So that your labor will not be in vain. We come here, we don't know what you're going through. If the Lord has not said it, we will know. But so many people are dying inwardly. So many people that commit suicide. There are certain things they cannot say. It is shameful. But I can trust you. If you can come out. If you can see some of the pastors, if you are come out and voice it out, the Lord will give you deliverance. His man is not too short that he cannot deliver. He will deliver you and you'll be a new person. If you know you have some addiction that is killing you, come out. Amen.
Amen.
I said what?
Come out.
Tell your neighbor, come out.
Come out.
And tell your neighbor, don't sleep.
Don't sleep.
This type of preaching, we don't sleep.
Amen.
Don't pretend like you are sleeping.
Amen.
You can hear me.
Amen.
If I had said the Lord will bless you, you would have jumped. Do you know what swines they do? When they throw up, they eat their throw up. They will go back to it. The Lord will bless you, and He will continue to bless you, and you will stay in the house of the Lord forever. That is why some of you, when the Lord bless you, we don't see you again. Every day we say it, we will continue to say it in Jesus' name. We will stop.
Amen.
Because we are not building an empire, we are building disciples for God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 The reason why some people die in silence in the house of God, number one, is pride. I don't preach. he says. But brethren, whatever I want to say is what I have practiced.
Amen.
And it's happening in my life.
Amen.
I'm not telling you listen to what I'm saying, but look at, don't look at what I'm doing. No! Pride is even killing pastors.
Yes.
They are dying in sin.
Yes.
Some pastors, they are falling, but they think they are standing. Because of pride. They are wounded, but they don't want nobody to know. They are still on the battlefield. It is dangerous. Some pastors that are taking other people's wives, drinking, and they will say all kinds of nonsense to cover up. It won't be long. He will come. He will come and he will separate the sheep from the. Those in sheep glory, but inwardly, they are dangerous wolves. The Bible says those are the people that sneak into people's houses and destroy their lives. Lucifer wanted to be equal with God. You, he has given want to rise up and be like him. The Lord said, no, two masters cannot be in a ship, in a boat. Two captains can never be here. Who dies? So I am going. I will teach you a lesson. When you go down and people start to step on you, then you will know that it is good for you to humble yourself. Very familiarity brings contempt. When somebody comes to the same level with you, don't raise your standard there. Because of pride, so many people are doing what they are not supposed to do.
Yes.
They don't belong, they want to belong.
Yes,
pride is ending people in jail. You don't have the money. You want everybody to know that you have it. You will go and steal just to prove a point. Me. I can never be you. You can never be me.
Amen.
That's right.
So don't be like somebody and end up your life. Hallelujah! If you do that, I'm telling you, you will be genuine. You will never be fake. And the Lord will continue to. Falling because of pride. They used to be very mighty. They used to be very powerful. Why? Pride. The devil wanted to be equal with God because God sits up there with them, talk to them, so that he thinks he's equal with him. Be careful with familiarity. Be careful.
Things
they don't even know.
Yes.
approach you does not mean I don't hear. Amen. I hear them. Amen. I don't care. Amen. You don't have a problem. I don't have a problem. Hallelujah. I don't have a problem with nobody. I love everybody. Amen. I think those people that gossip about me, they will think that what kind of person is she? Because they meet me, I smile to them. Don't go and explain me to someone because you don't know me. neighbor, it's about time we change.
Full of greed and self
Christians, we appear so clean and neat outside, but inside we are dying. It's full of all filthiness. That is why the Bible said, hypocrite. This Jesus was telling the scribes and the Pharisees. Don't live in pretense. Come out. The way you are inside, bring it out. Don't hide your real person. Don't pretend that you are standing. Meanwhile, you are falling. You won't get help. Say it now. Let everybody know. I need help. Don't pretend. Who are you pretending to? Did I die for you?
No.
Did I save you? Am I your savior? So who are you pleasing? You have to please the one that called you. The one that sees things in secret and rewards everybody openly. You have to. It is he that will give you your reward, not me. Don't live in pretense. Don't let everybody see you like you are angel. Meanwhile, you are not.
Amen.
Do you know that if you have problems with women, and if you don't change, even if you become a pastor, it will haunt you. Addiction is addiction. If you need help, you need help. If you are a leader, if you are a singer, if you are, and you see yourself in a situation that you cannot help it, voice it out.
Amen.
Don't pretend and sing. Meanwhile, you need help. You will sing for people to go to heaven, and you will end up in the lake of fire. You will preach. You will preach. As I'm preaching, people will change and go to heaven, but you will go to the lake of fire because of pretense. Don't preach what you don't practice.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Some people are so spiritual that when people are going to, oh my dear, your story is too much. I think maybe you are a sinner. Pray. Stop the pretense. We are all human.
Amen.
If I am falling short, don't judge me wrong. Hypocrites, they used to do the Pharisees. Then they have a beam in their eyes. And they are going to tell somebody that has the little spot. First, take out that thing you have, the big one. You will see Glenn, and then you will come to me and take my own. Pretense. Everybody is spiritual. In the house of God, everybody is spiritual. When it is Sunday, everybody is holy. After church, only God knows where you are going. After church, only God knows where you are what? Only God knows what you are going to do. You sit, you dance, Christian song, you go to the disco. Next door. You are like a chameleon. You change when the weather changes. Today you are green. Tomorrow you are white. Another day you are brown. Don't live in pretense. Women, it will be long. It is not going to be too long. The maker will come. Dangerous thing. A day of reckoning. A day that will be very sorrowful. Small sorrowful than Sodom and Gomorrah. Dangerous than Noah. A time of Noah. You sit down and take the grace of God for granted. And think that a day will not come. How can God destroy me? How can God destroy his handiwork? judgment in his hands. And he will pay everybody according to their works.
Because of gossip.
Yes, yes.
because of that. People are dying. They are dying silently. They cannot say it because of insecurity. Tell your neighbor you are secure with me. Are you sure?
Yes.
Tell your neighbor you can trust me. People are dying because of shame. The shame of it.
Yes.
The shame of it. How are people going to take it? How are they going to look at me? How are they going to take it? Because of that, people are dying. My friend, ignore the shame.
Yes.
Don't let nobody intimidate you.
Yes.
Come on, voice it out and you get up. Of this, voice it out. Let's open to Mark. We will read this for the last. Mark chapter 10. Mark chapter 10, please. 10 verse 47. Mark 10, 47 to 48. Amen. This story is about the blind Bartimaeus. How he got his deliverance. He screamed loud. He voiced it. He was not intimidated. People tried to bring him down. Look at what he did. Okay.
When he heard that it was Jesus in Nazareth, he began to cry out.
He began to make a noise.
Son of David.
Son of
Jesus,
have mercy on me. Yes, the next.
Many people told him to keep quiet.
You see, yes. Enemy of progress.
Yes. Was,
shut your mouth.
And he was crying out all the more.
He said, "You cannot intimidate me. You cannot shut me down. I am free. I can shout."
Have mercy on me.
He cried no more. Have mercy upon me.
Jesus stopped and said,
he said, his shouting attracted Jesus. His voice, he did not keep quiet, it attracted Jesus' attention.
Call in.
Call the blind man for me.
So they called the blind man.
Let's look at this. He was blind. He couldn't see, but he used his mouth. And he said, "I will scream."
So they called the blind man.
They called the blind man
and said to him.
And said to him,
"Have courage.
Have courage.
Get up.
Get up.
He's calling for you.
He's calling for you." And let's see what the man did.
He threw off his.
God, he did what?
He threw off his.
He threw off his shameful cloak. The cloak of shame.
Jump up. And came to Jesus.
Hallelujah. Yeah. Be on your feet today, you are going to shout.
Yeah.
You are going to take any shameful cloak away.
Yeah.
Any cloak of shame that the devil has put on you.
Yeah.
That is intimidating you, you cannot scream. Today you are going to scream aloud.
Yeah.
And the Lord is going to hear your story.
Yeah.
And you will draw Jesus' attention to you.
Yeah.
And Jesus will come and meet you at the point of your need.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. You are going to throw away every shameful cloak. Jesus is here today. He's going to set you free. Every shameful thing that the devil has put on you, that is keeping you silent. You can voice it out. You are dying only. Throw them away. Shout it! With your joyful voice. Bring your voice out. Let Jesus hear your story. Hallelujah. And you are going to be set free. Don't let anybody intimidate you. We have intimidators in the house of God. When you are doing something, you are bringing evil down.
Yes.
We are doing something for the Lord. Sit down. Since when did you come in? What are you doing? Why don't we put you down? Then they will not go. They will not allow nobody to pass them to. Enemy of progress. You who carry the load. found me.
Higher, higher, higher. There is something that makes me.